वेलकम क्लास। टुडे वी विल डील विद द टॉपिक डायमेंशनल एनालिसिस। व्हाट आर डायमेंशंस इन फिजिक्स? द बेसिक सेवन फंडामेंटल क्वांटिटीज आर नोन एज डायमेंशंस ऑफ फिजिक्स, दैट इज मास, लेंथ, टेम्परेचर, इलेक्ट्रिक करंट, टाइम, अमाउंट ऑफ सब्सटेंस, ल्यूमिनस इंटेंसिटी। दीज क्वांटिटीज आर नोन एज डायमेंशंस। डायमेंशंस मीन्स the quantities on which all other physical quantities are depends. Okay, so these dimensions we have to write in order to represent the derived quantities, that on which basic fundamental quantities these derived units or derived quantities depends. Okay, so starting from the basic quantities, how we can represent the basic or fundamental quantities in the form of dimensional analysis? See, mass can be written as m, length can be written as l, time can be written as t, temperature as k, current, electric current as a. Especially in class 11th, we need these three: mass, length and time. Okay, these three are required to represent the derived units or derived quantities in their form of dimensional formula. So what is dimensional formula or dimensional equation? When we are equating any quantity like this, equating any physical quantity to its dimensional formula, consider as velocity, then velocity is having dimensional formula L t minus 1. So this is dimensional equation. This is known as dimensional equation, because equation must have what? Equal to sign. Okay, so I'll teach you that how you can form or frame these dimensional formulas. Okay, so mass can be represented as m, length can be represented as l, and time can be represented as t. Okay, all the derived units are required to be converted into basic or fundamental units, and then from there we will change it into dimensional formula, and it can be represented by enclosing the fundamental dimensions in a square bracket. Okay, so the three things you need is, what are those three things which are required to frame the dimensional formula? Are first, the quantity; second, its SI unit; and third, converting it into basic units. Only three steps you have to do. For SI unit, you must know the formula of physical quantity. Okay, like force is equal to mass into acceleration, velocity is equal to distance upon time, or displacement upon time. So these formula you must know, then you can find the dimensional formula of any given quantity. Okay, so starting from velocity, let us see. Velocity is displacement upon time. Displacement is meter and time is second, so its SI unit will be meter per second. Meter can represented as L, because I have told you previously meter is the SI unit of length, and length is represented in the form of dimension as L, and second is for time, and power will be same, which is on basic units or SI unit, that will be same implemented for dimensional formula. So t is having power minus 1. It is not having kg or mass, because this quantity does not depend on kg or mass. Okay, so we will write the power of m, mass, as 0, and we are enclosing it in a square bracket. So this is the dimensional formula of velocity. Let us take more examples, like force, acceleration. First, acceleration is what? Velocity upon time. Okay, velocity is what? Meter per second, and time is second. It will become meter second to the power minus 2. Okay, so meter we can write as L. Meter means L, second means T, power is minus 2 and again it is not having mass. So mass will be what? 0. And this will be the dimensional formula for acceleration. Okay. So these basic formulas you have to learn. When you are going to write the dimensions of derived units, these basics you must know, the three steps: quantity, its SI unit or formula, and converted into basic units. Okay, this is step why I have written. Let us see for the different quantity where we are going to use it. Okay, let us see for force. What is the dimensional formula for force? Force is what? Mass into acceleration. So mass is what? Kg. Okay. Acceleration is what? Meter per second square. This is second step. We are converting its SI unit. SI unit is what? Newton. And we are converting its SI unit into its basic units. Okay. Now we can write its dimension formula because it is converted into basic or fundamental quantities units. Okay. Then force is equal to kg means mass, meter means L, and second means T power minus 2. This is the dimensional formula for force. Once again I am repeating, you have to write the formula of the quantity. That is, the quantity is force, formula is mass into acceleration. Now write the basic units, basic quantities and its unit. Mass is having unit as kg, acceleration as meter per second square. Kg is replaced by m because the dimensional formula of mass is capital M. Meter as L because it is length, and second as T because it is time. Power will be same here. Kg is having power 1, so M is power 1. Meter is having power 1, so L raised to power 1. Second is having power 2, minus 2, so T raised to power minus 2. This is the dimensional formula of force. Let us take another example. As momentum. So let us see for momentum. Momentum is represented by P and its formula is mv. First step is quantity, second step is its formula or SI unit. Okay, then SI unit, let us see. Meter is, mass is kg. Okay, and velocity is meter per second. Kg can be written as its dimension formula m, meter as L, and second as T, and power 1, 1 and minus 1. This is the dimensional formula for linear momentum, MLT minus 1. Don't forget to enclose this formula into a square bracket. Then it will become a dimensional equation. Now let us take another quantity, pressure. Pressure. Third example. Pressure is equal to force upon area. Now again, the same thing we have to do. We have to convert it into basic units. So force is mass into acceleration, and area is A. Mass means kg. Acceleration means meter per second square. Area means meter square. Now we have to solve it. Because here also meter, and the base we are also having meter denominator. So kg meter, when the bases are same and in division powers are subtracted, that is 1 minus 2, second minus 2. It will become kg meter inverse second minus 2. Now we are going to convert it into dimensional formula. Okay. So kg means m, meter means L, and L is having power minus 1. See, meter is having power minus 1. Second means T and power is minus 2. This is the dimensional formula for pressure. Okay, now you can practice for more quantities, more physical quantities, and to find its dimensional formula. Okay, and now in the next class we will discuss the other three applications of dimensional analysis. Okay, thank you class.